Now, despite police from the CIA, Pakistan reportedly gave the Chinese access to the crashed United States helicopter in Abbottabad after the raid on Osama bin Laden's compound. Our next guest says this is only the tip of the iceberg. He says the Chinese are stealing valuable U.S. secrets left and right, and says this is a real crisis and the U.S. better take notice. Welcome to Fox News strategic analyst Lieutenant Colonel Ralph Peters. Lieutenant Colonel, it's great to have you. So how big of a threat is this right now from China?
Well, it's an enormous threat. And as you observed, in the last few days, the media has focused on the fact that the Pakistanis, our supposed allies to whom we give billions every year, allowed the Chinese to rip off patches, samples from our stealth coating on the helicopter, to photograph it, etc. And that's important because it compromises military secrets. But as I hope we all know, the basis of a strong military isn't just the toys. It's really a strong economy. And China is assaulting our economy on multiple fronts with really grave attacks that Washington now realizes are happening but refuses to address. And I hate to, you know, I hate to add to the doom and gloom we've heard earlier in the show tonight.
Heard a little of that, yes. But go on.
Yeah, a little bit. But with China, we focus on the monthly trade deficits.
Right.
The real threat, I believe, is that China, with multiple, even hundreds of computer assaults every day on our government, our military, our major corporations, our banking system, they are stealing so much proprietary information that the mid to long-term cost to the U.S. economy may not be the trade deficit at all, but rather how much they have been able to steal. They steal from Google, they steal from General Electric, they steal from Lockheed Martin. And we're worried about our patent process, which does need to be improved in this country. The Chinese don't care about patents. They are stealing information.
And what are they doing with it exactly? Are they able to use this intellectual property and increase their own economy with it? I mean, is there actual application they're using with it? I mean, are there practical uses?
Well, that's a great question. And the answer is yes, no, yes, no, yes. They're able to certainly take our military secrets and use them to find vulnerabilities that they can attack because, you know, our military is much stronger. But if you can leverage the vulnerabilities, just as like in the financial world, you can get ahead. On the economic side, yes, they can copycat. They can copycat up to mid-high tech at this point. They still can't build a good jet engine. They still can't duplicate what Silicon Valley does. But remember, in the 1960s, we laughed at Japan. You know, they just made Jap junk, just radio, transistor radios. 20 years later, they were eating Detroit's lunch and making the best electronics in the world.
Yeah.
Now, so I don't want to overstate the Chinese threat, but Japan did that without stealing from us.
But is
it
about...
The Chinese are stealing everything they can steal.
Is it about overstating the threat, though, or is it about the U.S. government not doing enough to investigate and to penalize the Chinese for this intellectual property theft?
You are asking all the right questions. My
compliments. Well, thank you. I try. Well, I did my research.
Yeah, I know. Well, hey, great. But the problem is our government is so timid. Now, the Chinese were doing some of this under Bush, so it's not a new thing. But they've really assessed President Obama as very weak, and correctly so thus far. So they have really stepped up their computer network intrusions, their stealing of data, everything from personal data to proprietary data. And we know it's happening, but our government's response, which is worried about, oh, legality, what happens, the Chinese might retaliate, we're basically, we're sticking to defensive ball. We're playing only a defensive game. It's like somebody's robbing your house and you close your eyes and say, you shouldn't steal, you shouldn't steal. We need to hit the Chinese back and hit them hard. Otherwise, they will not get the message.
Lieutenant Colonel Peters, well, thank you for helping spread the message. Appreciate your time and your insights on this topic today.
My pleasure.